do here is to show you how to get onto the Commonwealth of Australia Corporation. We're going to find how go to Google, and I'll step you through how to find it on the net. We go to Google. I put in USSEC for United States Securities and Exchange Commission. And we've got it, United States Securities and Exchange Commission homepage. Click on that. This is the United States Securities and Exchange Commission. United States, this is, and the strange thing is that the United States Securities Exchange Commission was housed in Building 7 in the 9/11, when those buildings came down, or so-called attacked. This is the building that fell down by itself from the office fires. I think it housed the CIA, and also the United States Securities and Exchange Commission, that held all of the companies of the world, which is a bit of a strange. But we go to the top right-hand corner. More search options. And we come up with a search page. Company name, so we'll put in Commonwealth. Australia, we've already got it there. And what I do is I click on that starts with, I go over to contains, and then I come down to, not excludes, but includes the name. And then we come down here to company search. We come up with a page of all the possible links for Commonwealth of Australia. We've got Commonwealth Bank of Australia. It's also registered with the United States Securities and Exchange Commission. And down here is Commonwealth of Australia. So we'll click on that. And we've got it here. Commonwealth of Australia, 00008 05 157. Seal company filings. We've got even got the address. It's in Washington DC. That's the address of the Commonwealth of Australia Corporation, care of the Australian Embassy, Washington DC. What I do is I come down to the amended document, which is this one down here. It's amended. Click on that. Then we can find the form 18K, which is here, and that form brings up basically the front page that describes the company that we're looking at. It's a form 18K/A, amended number 1, for foreign governments and political subdivisions thereof, the United States Securities and Exchange Commission, Washington DC, annual report of the Commonwealth of Australia. This is the company that's registered to the United States Securities and Exchange Commission. This is the bank, but this is foreign. This is certainly not Australian, as we can see. We'll go down and find the CEO. It gives all the Mr. David Pearl. He's the minister for the economic minister from the Australian Embassy. So he would be housed in Washington DC. Then we all come down to I think it's Skadden and Apps. So the is the law firm or the accounting firm that looks after this. And we'll go down and we'll have a look at and we'll see who the boss of the Prime Minister of Australia at the moment, which is Tony Abbott. Well, let's see who his boss is. Dr. Ken Henry, AC, the Secretary of the Treasury of the Commonwealth of Australia. AC, I assume it's Order of the Eastern Star. Maybe it's a Masonic instrument. But there is something else you will notice about this this whole thing is that the writing is done in all uppercase text, which is the land of private or the jurisdiction of private contracts. It's called the glossa because the glossa is found in Black's Law Dictionary and the fourth edition that we've got. And it is a corruption of the essence of the text, which is the meaning, a corruption of the meaning of the text. The all uppercase text that is found in foreign contracts does not exist in the English language. It is a foreign language. So the Commonwealth of Australia, what this document is telling us, is that this company is foreign to any form of English or what we've assumed is Australian. This is a foreign banking entity. It has really nothing to do with Australians apart from the people that have joined this company and granted their estates, which is their dominion, which is the ownership of their share of the mineral and energy wealth of Australia, which is the dominion or the sovereignty. And we have granted this sovereignty to this company, this United States foreign company, and they now handle our affairs. But where we may have assumed that this company was an Australian-owned company, this is the evidence that it's certainly not. So that's how we find, this is the actual evidence that the Commonwealth of Australia Corporation, the one that's headed by Tony Abbott, and all the files, if you go into all the more files and everything, you'll see that this is the same company that they're running down in Canberra with the so-called Parliament House down there. It is an arm of the United States Federal Reserve.